I'm Jim Monahan from Professional Baseball Instruction and the Baseball Health Network, along with Steve Hayward, the founder of the Baseball Health Network, and Seattle Mariners prospect Patrick Kiblihan. And we want to talk to you today about an interesting journey to the doorstep of the major leagues, and that would be Patrick's journey. Patrick, you played football and baseball in high school, ended up going to Rutgers on a football scholarship, where you played football for 3 years, didn't play baseball at all. You play baseball senior year, and all of a sudden you get drafted in the fourth round. That's a very unusual story. How does that happen?
Coming out of high school, I had love for football and baseball, but I got a scholarship to play football at Rutgers, and it was a full scholarship, so I had to take advantage of that. And I knew right away, once the first baseball season went by that I didn't play, I missed it, and I started missing it more and more and more. And the commitment to do both would have been too hard. And after my senior year of football, I approached Coach Chiano about playing baseball, and he said, yeah, as long as your football commitments are through, you can do whatever you want. So I reached out to the baseball coach, asked for a tryout, and the rest is history.
Now, Steve, you had coached Patrick in high school. Did you see a sense that this was a guy who could get drafted?
Absolutely. We talked about it. When I asked him what colleges he wanted me to contact for him, and he said, no, I'm going to play football in college. And I was kind of like, you could get drafted. What he did his senior year, he broke the single season home run record at St. Joe's. Even with metal bats, he was hitting balls, 450 feet, and he's just an athletic kid. And I knew that he'd be able to get a chance to play pro ball if he stuck with it.
Now, playing baseball in high school and football, obviously, you were recruited for football. Were you also being recruited for baseball, or was it just football?
It was mostly just football. I kind of put myself out there as a football player, and so everyone, all the baseball coaches, kind of knew that I was a football player. So, yeah, I just put myself out there for football.
And yet at the same time, there were at least two other guys on that team who were drawing a lot of attention, one of whom just played in the major leagues this past year, and that would be Tommy La Stella, the infielder, and also Artie Lewicki, who's been drafted, and he's playing in the Detroit Tigers system. So sooner or later, somebody was probably noticing you if they're there looking at those two guys, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. We had a good team. We had a lot of other kids on the team that were playing college baseball, not just pro guys, but a lot of guys playing college ball. St. Joe's historically has been a baseball factory for Division I baseball players and guys getting drafted. And he's just one that slipped through the cracks.
Now, your senior year at Rutgers is one that the story is just amazing. And I use it here at Professional Baseball Instruction when I talk to some younger players that we have come in here. And that is, not only did you take 3 years off from baseball, but when you came back, it was as if you'd never stopped playing. Steve, what were the numbers that he put up?
He was the first person in Big East history to win the Triple Crown. He was the Big East player of the year, and he was drafted in the fourth round.
I thought baseball was supposed to be a hard game. You make it look easy.
It wasn't all roses the entire season. I actually got off to a rough start. I was the last kid on that team to actually get a hit that year, so when I finally got that monkey off my back, it was kind of smooth sailing, and I kind of just stayed hot.
Now, making the transition from football to baseball full-time, what did you do differently in terms of your training?
I definitely had to scale back my training. In football, it was all about how much you could bench press, how much you could squat, how much you could power clean.
As a defensive back, even as a safety?
Oh, yeah, it didn't matter what position. You just wanted to be as big and strong as possible. But switching over to baseball, it's kind of more about prolonging your body and, stretching, being ready for the entire season, the 140-game minor league grind, get ready for stuff like that. And, if you were too tight, as kind of in football, you bench a lot, you squat a lot, your body tends to tighten up because you're so muscle-bound. Baseball, you want to be looser, you want to be able to whip that ball across the diamond. Mm-hmm. So it's more about knowing your body more.
And let's talk about the difference in terms of the length of the season. College football, how many games would you play maximum when you were at Rutgers?
12 or 13.
Okay, 12 or 13.
If you got into a ball game.
High school baseball, how many are you playing?
Your season, your schedule is 25 games per season, and usually play, if you keep winning, you play up to 32 games.
So then you take that, you go play Rutgers baseball your senior year, probably like a 50-game schedule.
Yeah.
Short season A-ball.
Yeah.
You're up to about 120 games. That had to take an incredible toll on your body.
Yeah, that year was rough for me, going right from football into the college baseball into the short season, which had some brutal bus trips. So, definitely after that time, I needed to take a little break and get my body and my mind right.
So when you finished your first season of pro ball, were you completely exhausted? Was there, like you just said, take a little time off, but was there a sense of, wow, this was harder than I thought, this was more taxing in my body? What, do you remember what your mindset was?
It was more like a big blur, honestly. I mean, it was kind of like a little dream to go from football into this college baseball season where I really didn't have any expectations, to having the success I had, to going to my first pro season, to playing 71 of 72 games. I won the MVP of that league too, so it was kind of just a big whirlwind of a year. And you know, then I took that time to decompress a little bit and relax, and then it was more just excitement about getting going for the next year.
You make this baseball thing look pretty easy. So in planning for your second season, what were some of the things that you did, knowing what a grind it was? You're playing every day. What did you do differently?
Just relaxed a little bit. I didn't come out of the gate so hot. You know, kind of relax a little bit in spring training, not be so, you know, gung-ho, ready to go, sprinting everywhere. You kind of just relax and know it's a 140-game season. And you really got to last all 140.
And Steve, you played obviously as well at the professional level. You pitched for, I think, 5 years in the Red Sox system. Do you recall those days of going from high school to college and all of a sudden that expanded pro schedule, what it was like for you?
The jump from high school to college was definitely a big jump because, not only the amount of games, but the amount of practice time. And when I was in college, there were no restrictions on practice time. So we were practicing all day long, all night long. And then just the level that you were playing at, you know, to go from high school baseball to Division I college baseball, it's just a lot more challenging. It's a lot more high-stress situations, and it's just more taxing on your body.
Now, Patrick, we have a lot of kids who come here to professional baseball instruction. You work with many of them as well, who would like to someday live the dream that you are living, being right there on the doorstep of the major leagues. What do you tell that 10- or 12-year-old kid? You have, a different journey than a lot of them. Anybody who takes 3 years off from baseball and all of a sudden plays senior year of college, that's not going to happen for everybody.
Yeah, I would just tell them to, enjoy it and have fun with it. It's a great game, a fun game to play, and, play it as long as you can and as hard as you can because you never know when that last game's going to come and you don't want to have any bad regrets looking back.
Let's talk about the mental aspect of baseball just for a second. It's an easy game. You know, that line from Bull Durham, you throw the ball, you hit the ball, you catch the ball. If it was really that easy, we'd all be doing it. We'd all be making a gazillion dollars. The ability to accept failure, how do you do it?
For me, I mean, I accepted that was part of the game. Even as a young kid, I always knew that baseball came with failure. You know, unlike the generations that we're seeing now that have a much more difficult time dealing with failure. But to me, like, that's what makes it fun. You know, if it was really that easy, I don't think it would be as fun. I think it's the challenging part and the failure that actually makes you want to play more.
And Patrick, you mentioned when you walked on Rutgers senior year of baseball, you're the last guy on the team to get a hit.
Yeah.
As that monkey, you talked about that, is on your back and he's climbing higher and higher and higher, how did you handle that mentally?
I kind of just reverted back to, football and being, mentally tough and doing all those things we went through. And I had the mindset of, I've been through way more stressful situations than any of these guys have, and I know once I kind of get going a little bit, it'll all be easier.
And what's in pro ball? What's the longest stretch you've had where you've struggled?
Oof, at least a couple weeks of really, really struggling, not having good at bats, and then even if you do have a good at bat, you'll line out right to somebody, and the baseball guys just aren't on your side during that time.
And is again that football mentality? I've been through more than
yeah,
this.
Yeah, and I kind of play baseball too, knowing that I've been through slumps like this, I've been in tough situations before, and just know how to get yourself out of it.
It's a great story from a local athlete who's done what so many kids are trying to do. Patrick, thank you for your time. On behalf of Steve Hayward from the Baseball Health Network, I'm Jim Monahan. For more, go to baseballhealthnetwork.com.